And welcome, everybody.
I'm so tempted.
All right, everybody. We're going to play some new songs for you. This first one's called... Welcome
what
to the
don't
sandbox.
We were doing that for the last, like, 45 minutes.
All right. 45 minutes in 4 days.
It's all we've done the entire time.
13
should we
months.
Should we play a real song? Chester?
I would say we play a real song, but I'm going to speak in a fake accent. There's something inside me that pulls beneath the surface, consuming, confusing. This lack of self-control I fear is never ending, controlling. I can't seem to find myself again. My walls are closing in. I felt this way before, so insecure. Crawling in my skin, these wounds they will not heal. Fear is how I fall, confusing what is real. Discomfort endlessly has pulled itself upon me, distracting, reacting. Against my will, I stand beside my own reflection. It's haunting how I can't seem to find myself again. My walls are closing in. I felt this way before, so insecure.
Thanks, Brad.
I didn't have to do anything.
Dude, isn't it crazy to think that we wrote that song in this room like 17
when we were babies.
Years ago? Isn't that crazy? We were like kids, like little kids.
Yeah. This was, and I remember too that, like, I remember feeling as Rob's drums were over there, and we had like guitars over here and like sampler over here and stuff.
And Kiara was standing right
and
where
Kiara
she was.
Kiara was there back then in a cradle. Yep. And I remember like when it was like we had never like been in like such a nice studio. Do you remember that? I was like, whoa, like that's like a real drum kit with like real mic.
Dude, when we walked
sound.
In and there was like fruit and like veggies with toothpicks in them, we were like, man, that's fucking classy, dude.
Wow, that's great. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. Dang.
We've
like, arrived.
We've hit the big...
I might need to put some deodorant on before I walk through.
We've hit the big time. We deserve deodorant and fruit.
I can't let them know. Nobody can know I'm sleeping in my car right outside the building.
Well, I can tell that there's... Little do they know, there's like 1,000 people in the other room like waiting for us to like move along. So we have a new song, and it's called Heavy... And there's a fourth person in the room here.
Hi.
Kiara.
Hey.
How are you?
Good.
We are, the song, it was so fun making the song. And you sound great on it.
She took it to another level.
Another level.
Because it was awesome before she sang on it. And then it became like the no-brainer first single like after she sang on it. So.
And it's available for those of you guys watching at home. It's available now. And
should we play it?
We should play it.
Let's play it.
We should play the song. So this is called Heavy.
I don't like my mind right now. Stacking up problems that are so unnecessary. Wish that I could slow things down. I wanna let go, but there's comfort in the panic. And I drive myself crazy, thinking everything's about me. Yeah, I drive myself crazy, 'cause I can't escape the gravity. I'm holding on. Why is everything so heavy? Holding on. There's so much more than I can carry. I keep dragging around what's bringing me down. If I just let go, I'd be set free. Holding on.
Why is everything so heavy? You say that I'm paranoid, but I'm pretty sure the road is out to get me. It's not like I make the choice to let my mind stay so fucking messy. I know I'm not the center of the universe, but you keep spinning around me just the same. I know I'm not the center of the universe, but you keep spinning around me just the same.
I'm holding on. Why is everything so heavy? Holding on. Just so much more than I can carry. I keep dragging around what's bringing me down. If I just let go, I'd be set free. Holding on. Why is everything so heavy? I know I'm not the center of the universe, but you keep spinning around me just the same.
We should record that.
You know what's funny is that's that I was just thinking like earlier that that's how all the songs on the record started, right? Like they were all, normally we have like when we're writing an album, we're making more tracks and it's like a very like full sonic thing, and that inspires
the vocal, right?
The vocal.
And you know what's interesting about that is like, what's instant gratification? Like huge guitars, like just like tons of like rock music, like
sounds,
just like
yeah.
Raw, you know, it's like I want to do that, you know. Mm-hmm. But like when we started singing and writing lyrics, yeah, over chord progressions, it really helped us just create these great melodies and these great lyrics, and then really put together like almost the arrangement of the song like that, like right away.
Yeah.
And by the end of the day we had a song, like a full song, and then it was a matter of just building the track to support the melody and, yeah, the lyrics,
and building the track
is awesome.
Like, building the track is like the almost like the easier part. It's the fun, at least for us. It's like the
fun. Yeah,
it's fun,
part. And yeah. And it just it really shaped the dynamic and like how the whole tone of the record.
Yeah.
I remember actually like singing almost all the, like singing a lot of like the main vocals that are on the record over just piano or like acoustic,
yeah,
guitar tracks.
Yeah.
And then on some of them, I was in there like just like, you know, like in like just like trancey,
sleepy
kind of vibe,
yeah,
and I had to come back, and like those are the ones that had to come back. Like once we built the track, I was like, okay, this needs a little more energy.
But trance like is like the word, because it, what you were in like a like this vibe, you were vibed out into the song, and in some of those, some cases like there's on One More Light on the album, there's 10 tracks, and of those, I bet you like a third of them, we kept a lot of the original vocal, and it has this trance, like you're in, so like because there's no music going on, so it's all in your head.
It's just,
you know?
Like, it's
and yeah,
pure.
And you're like vibed out on the vocal.
There's nothing. I don't have to like think over any sounds. Yeah. I'm just like singing over the chords, which is really, it helped me out a lot, and it helped me learn the songs really well mm-hmm. before I came in and like crushed out a vocal, which was something that we never did before. Like I was always mm-hmm. like kind of thinking about what I was doing in the studio. Yeah. So anyways, it was really more fun for me on this record than any other record, because I actually like felt like I knew what I was doing when I was doing the vocals.
Cool. Do you guys want to do another one?
I do another one.
We wrote Burn It Down right in that room behind us.
We did. And I remember coming in
right
here
there.
And being like, We the vocal wasn't like the lyrics weren't done. You know what? Like what we learned to do in time is like if the song wasn't done, to like just break it down to just the guitar or piano, be like, okay, so like, like, and figure it out as we were playing.
I remember doing like melodies on the piano in here.
Yeah.
And trying to figure out where my range was fun.
Yeah, that's right.
Remember,
that's
I was right. like, that's kind of high, you know, or
Dang
like.
It.
Yeah, it's like funny.
Yeah.
So. Cool, let's play it.
Cycle repeated as explosions broke in the sky. All that I needed was the one thing I couldn't find, and you were there at the turn, waiting to let me know. We're building it up to break it back down. To fix this, but couldn't stop from tearing it down. And you were there at the turn, caught in the burning glow. And I was there at the turn, waiting to let you know.
That right to hold that crown. I built you up, but you let me down. So when you fall, I take my turn. Fan your flames as your blazes burn.
And you were there at the turn, ready to let me know. We're building it up to break it back down. So
infinite sustain.
You can be in the band. You can be in the band now.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you,
yes,
guys.
Hey,
where did you come from?
Hey. You guys are ready?
We should
Shoot a band or something. What are you guys up to?
Sounded great.
Okay. Nice. Do your awesome shenanigans again?
Yeah,
that's amazing. What's
so,
up, guys?
So there, we've got some questions from fans.
Spread out and explore the studio space.
We've got some questions from fans.
We've also got iPads. Which is
we've got questions on iPads, and the first one is from Samir. Oh, this is an interesting question, you guys. Did you guys decide the genre when writing the song? So I think that means like, as you're writing it, or
yeah, was it a conscious was the style of the music that we wrote for this record a conscious decision?
What do you think?
I think that I don't know, Brad. What do you think?
I think the song writing itself really drove the creative process, like the words, the emotion behind the song, and then what you guys were talking about earlier, how like typically we'd go music and then song. By starting with song this time, what was a cool challenge was actually finding the arrangement and the music that felt like the song, that really complemented the emotion
and
of
also,
the vocals.
Like really what, I mean, what I feel like what really like moved the meter on the songs was actually like the conversations that we were having about our lives. Like that really dictated the style of the songs, like how we were feeling when we were singing and writing the music. Like we weren't really thinking about musical style or musical anything. We were really thinking about our lives and like what was in and what was going on in our lives, positive or negative, or experiences we were having in our relationships with people or whatever, or with ourselves. Like that's what really drove the record, you know? And like, I feel like this album is like a pure, is a direct response. The style of the songs are like a direct response to the emotions that we were feeling when we were writing this, the lyrics and melodies.
Kiara, I have a question for you. It's not, it's, I mean, based on that, like when you came in, like Zane Lowe had introduced us and you came in, we hung for a second. That first time we met, did I play you anything? Do you remember if I played you anything that first time?
You did, yeah.
I did.
Okay, you played, so it was like, really, really new. Like, it was in the process, though. Really,
yeah, because I felt like you came into the middle to a, at a time when we were still like figuring out the what the record was going to sound like, and we had all kinds of different like experiments going on with the music. So, like, how did that hit you? Because I know, like, when Zane had told me, hey, you should check out, like, Kiara came in, do you know who that is? I was like, yeah, you had put out Gold and that EP, and I was like, I love her stuff. And he's like, yeah, she's into the band. It's like, I said, what's your favorite band? She's like, Linkin Park. And I was like, I would never have guessed that based on the sound. And when we got in touch, I was like, I think I said to you, like, you're going to be surprised by what this sounds like. Because in my head, I was thinking, it's actually like a little closer to your music than you probably would have guessed. Mm-hmm. Was that true?
Yeah, it was like, I don't know how to describe it. When I heard it, it made complete sense, but it was obviously like really different.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It was really, I mean, was like, for us, we were like trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
I'm sure it was probably easier for you to wrap your head around if they're, you know, with this style that we were presenting as opposed to like a death metal song.
Hey, will you come sing?
No, I was like,
it's a guilty all the same. Will you sing on this?
Someone in her camp was wearing a Metallica shirt today, so I think there's a little death metal just under the surface.
Perfect.
They're death metal on the inside. That's good
enough. The next question is from Gabriela Modesto Carrillo. Hope I did that justice, Gabriela. What were your ideas for the new logo design?
That's a pretty simple one. I mean, like, we wanted to keep the basic shape of the LP, but we actually, on a lot of this new stuff, we added six sides because there's six members of the band and everybody's kind of a different. So
it's also an homage to the death metal in us, the number six.
I like how you tied that in. It was well played.
It goes back to the previous question.
Yeah.
Or the previous answer.
Is this Javen Rosales?
Javen.
Will you guys be touring in 2017?
Yes.
That's the simple answer.
Great. Francesca De Mayo said, wow, we've got a lot of...
The complicated answer is also yes.
A lot of Latin names. She came on tour with LP. Oh, I think she's asking if you're going to tour with us.
I hope so.
That would be fun, right?
That'd be awesome.
Yeah. Joyce Chan asks, "How does Kiara feel? How do you feel about working with LP? What's it like?"
Don't sugarcoat
it. It's like, seriously, I'm not. It's really overwhelming because, like, in the best way, because it's like my brain can't process how I'm standing in this room, you know. So I try not to think about it, but it's amazing.
That's how I feel around these guys.
Yeah,
I can't believe I'm still standing in the same room with these
kind of wild,
you know, really funny, handsome guys.
It's funny, Kiara, but like, I have to remember, like, I just look at you as one of our peers. Like, you're a professional musician. You have great music out, like, equal playing field. But I have to, like, remember that, like, we've been doing this for a really long time.
Yeah.
And this is your, like, I think your first show was Lollapalooza, like, last year, right?
Yeah.
So that's pretty badass,
by
the
way. It was kind of
We haven't even played Lollapalooza, so.
Maybe you can introduce us.
Yeah, could you, like, make that happen for us? Because, like, you know, like, you're way more connected than we are. But it's funny, like, I have to remember, like, oh, yeah, like, this is, like, all new for her. Like, I might want to, like...
Like, you know what we're talking about, right?
I'm like, no,
I don't have any clue what's going on. So, yeah, it's pretty funny. But you carry yourself really well.
Chester and I were at a 21 Pilots show last night. And it was so funny because I had my oldest daughter with me, my wife, and then my oldest daughter brought one of her friends with her, two friends, actually. And Chester's sitting right behind us. It's our family and friends that are sitting right here. Chester's right behind us. And one of her best buddies is this kid who's just, like, a huge music fan. And so for him, he's gone to two concerts. One was Dave Matthews Band, and somehow he got Carter's drumstick in the process.
Wow.
Which they had to explain to him, like, this is not normal for going to a concert. His second concert was last night, 21 Pilots, and he's sitting in front of Chester. And Chester's talking with them, obviously, because you're talking with Regan, talking with all the kids, they're having so much fun and whatever. And then his parents now have to explain, like, okay, also doesn't happen when you go to a concert that you get to sit in front of, like, one of your favorite singers of all time, and he talks to you and hangs out.
I gave a bunch of Linkin Park stickers.
Yeah, Chester's handing out, like, Linkin Park stickers. These kids are just stoked. So it's so funny. I'm having to explain to my daughter then after the fact, like, why was her friend freaking out? It's like, why? I don't get it. Like, on the drive home, why was he just going nuts and crazy about it? I'm like, well, some people get a little weird around Chester.
not saying that's you. That's more me.
Okay.
We have a question from, I think it's Sven Gruning. When is the release of the album? Answer is, am I getting it
May
right?
19th.
May 19th. Yeah. May 19th.
Yeah, if you pre-order the record.
That's up on LinkinPark.com.
If you pre-order the record, you'll see the release date underneath the album artwork.
Yeah. And we've got a bunch of cool packages on LinkinPark.com now. Vinyl, book, like this thick, nice, like, photo book and stuff from all, like, with all the photos. And we've also got these really cool little pins for, like, different levels. It's like, if you get the, like, super cool level, you get all the best stuff. So that's on LinkinPark.com. Emil
Taib asks, Johan, what was the inspiration for your new haircut?
I'm not
Wait a minute.
I have a question for Kiara. When you come in here and you meet us, is it like these guys are old?
No.
Only old on the inside.
Only you, Joe.
It's more, I feel like I'm, like, on the inside really old. No.
Wait, what did you say?
I feel like on the inside, I'm, like, really old.
You're old.
I'm just like, but no, it didn't.
Jacek Woodcox asks, what was the best part about writing this new amazing song?
You know, honestly, like, I feel like there was a lot of new excitement and inspiration brought into the process of writing the songs for the new record by inviting outside collaborators to come in and work with us, because like, just from an outsider, like, just from, like, being in the band and also being able to watch from, like, a distance, at certain times, like, Mike and Brad are always in the kind of controls, like, in controlling what's going on and creating and, like, kind of producing, and, like, they're wearing a lot of hats, and it was really fun to see other writers come in and then just watch Mike like write songs, like not produce anything, not like think about sounds or think about anything other than like writing a song. And the same with Brad. And I think that like that was like really fun for me to see, because I've been, you know, in the group for 18 years, and that kind of like intensity in the writing process, not that it's been missing, it just is, it felt like it was like exciting for you and fun and like supercharged. Like you were just like,
because part of it, I mean, part of it was like
fun to watch.
Part of it was like working with all these new people. I know that you guys felt it too when you came in. Like sometimes it was different combinations of guys in the room, like different. Yeah. And that's what it was like. The variety was really fun, I thought.
For me, making this album and like a lot of the ways we've approached making the album, talking about the album, even like supporting the album, it feels, a lot of it feels like doing it for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Because like it'd be easy to just like take things for granted and be like, oh, this is how we always do X, Y, and Z. And I feel like from day one, the kind of like the ethos of this is like, let's discover, like, let's learn, let's discover, let's open ourselves up to seeing things, even maybe something we have done a lot of times, but by approaching it in a different way or seeing it from a different vantage point, for me it feels like the first time. Like I almost felt like last night I was like, it's almost like hard for me to go to sleep because I was so excited mm-hmm. for the song to come out. And even that's kind of like weird, right? Because we've had a lot of songs come out, but a lot about this album just feels like a first for me. I don't know why.
Dude, think about how we all felt when we started sitting in rooms with other writers, and like we'd make small talk and like, oh, the weather's nice, and like, ah, the studio couches are comfortable. Like it was like, and then, you know, I think at one point I like something was going on in my life. I was like, do you guys really want to know what's going on in my world right now? And like, just being able to be like, just opening up in front of someone that we don't know. It's not part of our inner circle. Like we always keep everything so inside. Yeah. And so like, and then really talking about like the, some of the, like, dude, all of us have gone through some crazy shit in the last couple of years. Mm-hmm. And we like decided to write all that stuff down and be like, this is what's inspired. Like, what's the inspiration behind the music? And it's like, this is the, you know, we wrote all the stuff that each one of us went through on a piece of paper in the last couple of years. And it was like, holy crap, like that's been our lives. And that's what, when we realized like life is the inspiration for this, and being open about it and talking about it and then writing songs about how we feel about those things, that was even new. You know, mm-hmm. It was like every part of the process felt like exciting and almost kind of uncomfortable, and like we definitely got out of our comfort zone on this record for sure.
Yeah, I thought one of the cool things about that is that like during the process of making the record, some of the lyrics and the music, it was almost like it was forecasting like what was happening in all of our lives, like slightly, it was like slightly ahead of where we were and what we were talking about, because it was like, that's the stuff that comes from the heart, from like really deep down inside, and it's coming out in the music before like we even knew like cognitively what was happening. So mm-hmm. It's like, as you were saying, Chester, as we were like opening up and talking more with each other, I think becoming closer as a band, like the music reflects that.
There have been a couple questions about stylistic stuff. Like there's a question from Brett Aiello about Brad's guitar tone. There's a question about rapping on the record. There's a
dude, you're going to gloss over the fact that this kid wrote, I love the tone of Brad's guitar.
Oh, I'm
just going to paraphrase
it. Didn't phrase it that way. Okay.
Thanks a lot, man.
So there, that's
really
true.
Good looking out.
The reason that I was focused on the other part is because in terms of like style, like I've been getting a lot of questions about, oh, like the style of the song, like is the does the album sound like that? And I say, yeah, like it sounds, I mean, there's variety on the album, obviously, but
you mean style, sound like heavy? Or
yeah, sound like sound like the song Heavy. And I think for us, like what it does come back to is that, you know, even when we're like sharing songs with each other, oh, have you heard this song? Have you heard this song? Have you heard that song? Like we all like a lot of different styles of music, and that's what our band has always been built on, you know, is that like the hybrid theory, the mashing up of different things. And so it's in terms of like a specific genre or style or stylistic approach or whatever, it's really like, I don't feel like we tried to do any of that. Like it's kind of just, we're just doing our own thing.
I think we're really lucky to get to do what we do. We have literally the best fans in the world, and we couldn't be more honored to have you here with us. Kiara, you're so talented. Your voice is so dope.
Thank you.
And you really like took the song over the top, and we're really, really proud of it. So thanks for sharing this with us.
No, thanks for having me on it.
And thanks to everybody for tuning in to our live performance and our Q&A. We really appreciate all of our fans. Like, for real, like, we've got the best fans in the world. Like, can't say that enough. And we love you guys for joining us on our musical journey. And we can't wait for you guys to hear more of the record. And, you know, next time we talk, we'll get into the reason why everything's so heavy, I guess, because that was a good last question. But we have to move on. All right, so thank you, everybody. Thanks, Kiara.
Thank you.
My mind right now, stacking up problems that